Spreadsheet Podcast, episode number one. Type 12-13 becomes 13 December. Hey, welcome back to Don't Fear the Spreadsheet. I'm Bill Jell from Mr. Excel. Here's our today's question from Tyler Nash.
All right, Mr. Excel, I've about had it with Excel. Every time I put in 12-13, Excel changes it to December 13th. I don't want a date. I don't want December 13th. I want 12-13. Why can't Excel handle that?
Oh, Tyler, that's a good one. Excel is actually trying to make your life easier there. What they're doing is they're trying to recognize anything that looks remotely like a date, and they're changing it to a date. So, you know, people enter dates a lot of different ways in Excel, and they always want to change it to a real date. And we'll talk later in the book about why real dates are important. And you're being stung there because they think when you type 12-13, you mean December 13th. See, they even put in 2012 for you. It's a great shortcut key. It's a great thing if you're trying to put in a date. But if you're not trying to put in a date, if you're trying to put in something else, well then, oh, it's really frustrating. And for all the people who've been using Excel out there for a long time, they instantly know the answer to this. They say, oh, well, you have to put an apostrophe first. Put the apostrophe and then type your 12-13. And Tyler, I can already hear what you're saying. What? An apostrophe? How was I supposed to know that? Well, it's a really long story. It goes back to the days of Lotus 1-2-3 and probably even to VisiCalc, where that apostrophe would say, hey, this is not a number. Don't treat it special, just you know, leave it as text. It's kind of a shortcut key for coming in here and doing home and then changing the format to text, and then you can type whatever you want without having the apostrophe, but most people, I think, just use the apostrophe. Well, hey, all right, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another podcast. Mr. Excel and Tyler Nash. Check out Don't Fear the Spreadsheet, the book that makes Excel for Dummies look like it was written for rocket scientists.